Hello students, we will take few unsolved problems of chapter 4 wave motion. So the first problem is the amplitude of transverse wave is 10 cm. So what is given to you? A is 10 cm, or we can say in short 0.1 meter. Right? The velocity of the wave is 330 meters per second. So we can say 3 is equal to 330 meters per second, and the frequency is 330 hertz. So either we can say f or nu, which is also 330 hertz. Now we need to write down the equation of wave motion along the positive direction of x-axis. Okay. So what is the equation in case of transverse wave? Now what is transverse wave? We already repeated in I think my first video. And suppose this is a support to which we have attached a thread, and this part is in your hand, and if you just shake your hand, you are going to observe that the transverse wave is going to pass. That's what is the origin of this transverse wave. So as far as the equation is concerned, we have the equation, which is y is equal to a, the amplitude, sine of omega t minus kx. This is my form or the equation. Now out of this, what is omega? Omega is equal to 2 pi nu, correct? So how much is my nu? Nu is 330 hertz, fine? And what is C? The formula for C is omega by K, fine? So we have been given C, so we can find out K very easily. So we can say, therefore, omega is equal to CK, or K is equal to, okay, omega by C. So what is omega? I said it is 2 pi into 330, because 2 pi nu, and what is C? Is even C is 330. So if you get cancelled, we get the value of K to be 2 pi. Fine. So we are ready. We know A, we know omega, correct? Omega is CK. And we know, omega is this value also know, and K also we know. So therefore we can write y is equal to 0.1 is my amplitude, sine omega t. How much is omega? I said 2 pi into 330 t minus K. How much is K? 2 pi x. Correct? So here we can take 2 pi common and write 2 pi inside the bracket, it is 330 t minus x. So this is my equation of the wave motion. This is the way we can solve the simple problem. Okay. Now the second problem, a metal wire of length 50 cm weighs 5 grams. If it is stretched by a force of 10 newtons, what would be the speed of the transverse wave passing on it? Right? So we have been asked a simple question to find out the value of C, velocity, or the speed of transverse wave. So what is the formula for transverse wave? C is equal to T by mu. Correct? So in this case, we have been given the value of you will need to know T and mu. So what is this T or tension? Tension or the force is given by 10 newtons. And what is this mu? Mu is mass per length. So as far as mass per length is concerned, how much is the mass given to you? Mass is 5 grams. Correct? So mass we will have to convert in kg. Correct? So how much that will become? That will become, in short, 0.005 kg, because 1 kg is 1000 grams, so we will have to convert 5 gram into how many kgs. Similarly, length is how much? It is 50 centimeter. Make that into meters, so that will be only 0.5 meters. Correct? So therefore, my value of mu will be 0.005 divided by 0.5. That will make it 0.01. Fine. Substitute the value over here. So we can say, therefore, my C will be under root 10 divided by 0.01. That will give me under root 1000, and that should be 31.62 meters per second. This is the final answer. So this is my speed of a transverse wave passing on it. Correct. So this is the way we have finished with question number 2. Now we'll move towards question number 3. Now next question. The equation of transverse wave motion is expressed by y is equal to y0 sine 2 pi 0.005x minus t in a bracket if maximum velocity of a particle is 44 centimeters per second. Find the amplitude of the wave and calculate wave velocity also. Correct. So over here I wrote the equation again, y is equal to y0 sine of 2 pi 0.005x minus t. Now in this case they have asked us to find out amplitude and they have given us maximum velocity of a particle. Now what is maximum velocity of a particle? That we'll write down first. So if y is this, so what is my daba y by daba t? Daba y by daba t will be t. So t is over here. So the value will be minus 2 pi, because 2 pi t, correct? Minus sign, so minus 2 pi into this y0 as it is. Derivative of sine will be cos of 2 pi inside the bracket 0.005 x minus t, and this value is given out to be this value 2 pi by 0. This is given out to be maximum velocity is equal to 2 pi by 0, and that value has given it to be 44 centimeters. So we can say this is 44 centimeters per second. So therefore we can say y0 is equal to 44 divided by 2 pi, or 44 divided by 2 into 3.14. so if you simplify this, we will get the answer to be around 7 centimeters. So my first answer is done. Find the amplitude of the wave. I got the answer 7 centimeters. Now, the next thing they ask is wave velocity. So, wave velocity is what? C. I need to find out C. What is the formula for C? C is equal to omega by k. Now, in this equation, correct? What is the equation we can say? Equation is equal to y is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. So, what is my k value? So if at all we compare, we can say value of k is given by 2 pi into 0.005, and how much is omega? This is omega. Omega will be 2 pi. Fine. So put the value over here. So we can say therefore C will be 2 pi into 0.005. Omega is 2 pi, yeah. So omega is 2 pi divided by k is 2 pi into 0.005, cancel 2 pi, so 1 upon 0.005. okay, so if you simplify this, we will get the answer to be around 200 centimeters per second. So this is the way we have got the value of wave velocity which is asked over here. So we have first found out the amplitude, and now we have found out the wave velocity over here. This is second answer, correct? Next question, question number 4 is calculate the energy density and intensity of a plane progressive wave of frequency 300 hertz. So we can say nu or f to be 300 hertz. Amplitude 0.007, so we can say A is equal to 0.007 centimeter. Velocity, so we'll say C is equal to 33,000 centimeters per second. and the density is given out to be 1.293 into 10 to the power minus 33 gram per centimeter cube. So first thing we have to find is energy density. So the formula I taught you, that was 2 pi square nu square density into a square. Fine. So 2 into 3.14 bracket square into frequency is 300 into density is 1.293 10 to the power minus 3 multiplied by 0.007 bracket square. 0.7, I suppose, not 007. 0.7, I made a mistake here. Okay. 0.07. So here also 0.07 square. Okay. So if you simplify this, we will get the answer to be around 11.244 ergs per centimeter cube. Correct? If these values would have been given in MK system, we would have written the unit joules per meter cube. But this is ergs per centimeter cube. Now, after finishing energy density, what is the next thing? Intensity. So what is the formula for intensity I? Intensity I is 2 pi square nu square rho a square into c. So everything is over here. So we can also write I is equal to e nu into c. So whatever is his answer, multiply only by c. Correct? So we can say I is equal to 11.244 into, how much is the value of velocity given to you? C, which is 33,000. So if you multiply this, you will be getting the answer, which is 371,056.7 ergs per centimeter square second. So this is the answer for intensity, 371,056.7 ergs per centimeter square. Would have been MKs, would have been joules per meter square second. Fine. We'll move towards question number 5. Next question. Question number 5. Write down the equation of simple harmonic progressive wave of amplitude 0.01 centimeter. So we'll have to make it in meters. So I can say L0 is the amplitude, which is 0.01 centimeter, or 0.01 into 10 to the power minus 2 meters. This is my L0. And frequency is 100 hertz. So we can say the value frequency will be nu is 100 hertz. Traveling in the negative direction, important word, with a velocity of 3. So c is 330 meters per second. Right. Now we have to write the equation for the simple harmonic progressive wave. So as I mentioned, L is equal to L0, we know already, sine of kx minus omega t. So what is k over here? K is nothing but 2 pi by lambda. Fine. So if k is 2 pi by lambda and the value of k is equal to omega by c. Fine. Substitute the value. So omega is 2 pi nu divided by c. So we can do it this way, or we can get even this fashion also, lambda is equal to c by nu. Anyway, we can, whatever the things are given, we'll have to manage, or we'll have to adjust the terms and get the answer. So if lambda is c by nu, will this help to me? I think this will help to me. So what is my value of c? C is given to be 330 meters per second. And what is nu? Nu is 100 frequency. So if we cancel this, we get lambda to be 3.3. Fine. Now, if at all I want to write this equation, I'll write L is equal to L0 sine, correct? As I mentioned, 2 pi by lambda and 2 pi nu. K is 2 pi. So I'll write this 2 pi nu x minus 2 pi by lambda, 2 pi by lambda into t. Fine. So this will help me write the equation properly. So I'll write sine of 2 pi x by lambda, correct? So we'll write that in the fashion x by 3.3 minus t by 100. Why? Because 2 pi by lambda is, I mentioned, to be k, and that value is 3.3. Perfect. And the frequency is how much? T by t, correct? So if at all you want to write that number, so we are going to get the equation to be, okay, or I'll do one more thing, I'll write the equation first. So L is equal to L0 sine 2 pi x by lambda minus t by capital T. Even this will do. This will be better first. So we'll write this equation instead of this equation. So 2 pi x by lambda, okay, minus t by t. So now substitute the values. So we get L is equal to L0, which is 0.01 10 to the power minus 2 sine of 2 pi x divided by lambda, I showed you 3.3, this is better, minus t by t. Now we said frequency is how much? T is equal to 1 upon nu, or 1 upon f. F is 100. So I am writing here t by 100. So this is the way we can write the equation, correct? So this is the way I got my final expression to be L is equal to 0.01 10 to the power minus 2 sine of 2 pi x by 3.3 minus t by 100. Fine. Because here 3.3 was my lambda, correct? And t was my 1 upon 100 as it is. Okay. We'll move to the next problem. We'll move to the next question. Before that, the mistake what I made over here, I'll just repeat again. L is equal to L0 kx. So I made a mistake. I wrote here 2 pi nu, so it is 2 pi by lambda, because k is 2 pi by lambda and omega should be 2 pi nu. Okay, so then there will not be any issue. So lambda is 3, values are correct, lambda is 3.3, and then the value of frequency omega will be over here adjusted well, correct? So the next question, the energy density of a plane progressive wave in a medium is 3 ergs per centimeter cube. So which means they have been given you E nu. What is the value of E nu? 3 ergs per centimeter cube. If the wave velocity, that is C, in the medium is 33,000 centimeters per second, find out I. Correct? Already we have solved one problem in this. The formula for I is how much? Energy density into C. Correct? So what is energy density? Energy density is 3 ergs per centimeter cube. And what is C? C comes out, given out to be 33,000 centimeter per second. So 1 centimeter goes, and we get I to be 3,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, This is the answer for the question number 6. Right? We'll move to the next question. Next question. Question number 9. Write an equation describing a sinusoidal transverse wave traveling on a chord in positive direction with a wavelength. So lambda is given. Wavelength 10 centimeter. Frequency f, or you can say nu, which is 400 hertz. And amplitude, that is a, is 2 centimeter. Alright. So what is the equation for the transverse wave? We have seen y is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. Okay. Now, after solving so many questions, we know very well what is the value of k and what is the value of omega. So this only we should know. So we have said k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. Lambda is given out to be 10. Right. So we know how to solve this very easily. So the answer for k will turn out to be around 2 pi by lambda is, okay, first is lambda is given out to be 10 centimeter. So we'll have to make it in meters first. So I'll write, instead of 10 centimeter, I'll write 2 pi by 0.1. Correct? So if you simplify this, correct, we will be getting the answer, that is 62.8. Okay, 2 into 3.14 divided by 0.1, so that 0 will go up, 62.8. Next is omega. What is omega? 2 pi nu. Nu is the frequency. So 2 into 3.14 into nu is 400 hertz given. So if you simplify this, you get the value 2512. Correct? So therefore, my equation will be y is equal to a. A is how much? 2. Correct? So a is 2, or a is 2 sine kx. So k is how much? 62.8 times x minus 2512t. Correct? So this is the way we got the answer. So even though we can make this also in meters, correct? So if at all you make this in meter, so make it, so y is equal to, change that value correspondingly, sine, this will remain same, 62.8 minus 2512t. So this is what the answer. Or even though you make this 10 centimeter also, not an issue. So just check this answer then accordingly. Okay, so this is the way we can simply get the equation for a transverse wave traveling on a chord in positive direction. Okay, we'll move towards the next question. Okay, so in the last question, I suppose better to make this meters, so that I'll make it 0.02. Otherwise, then we'll have to convert them. Okay, so 0.02 meters sine 62.8x minus 2512t. Next, again a little interesting but little different problem. Suppose that sound is emitted uniformly in all directions by a public address system. The intensity at a location 22 meter away from the sound. So we can say I22 is 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 watts per meter square. What is the intensity at a spot that is 44 meter away? So we need to find out I44. Fine. Suppose we show this by diagrammatically. Suppose this is my source. And I said that around 22 meters away, okay, I got the intensity. Suppose I draw this a circle and say that intensity at this point is 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 watts per meter square. I need now how much from that same source, go little more. This is 22, so I have to go little more. Okay, this is 44 meters away, and here I need to know how much is the intensity now. That is the question asked. Fine. So What I can say, this is spherical now, so I'll have to take the formula accordingly. So I can say the formula I22 is equal to power divided by area, correct? So I'll say area 22. So in this case, I can say the formula for power is equal to intensity into area at the 22, means area 22 means 22 meter away, that I mean. So what is the value given of the intensity? Intensity given is 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 into area. Now area will be, this is sphere. So we'll say 4 pi r square. How much is r? 22. So I'll say 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 into 4 pi 22 square. R square, 22 meter square. So this is my first expression. Now what I want I44. So this is given, I suppose we can say. So I44 meter away is equal to the P divided by area 44. So what will change? Only 4 pi into 44 square will change. So how can I find out that value? So I can say this P is the same P. So I can say 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 into 4 pi into 22 bracket square divided by area. How much is area? 4 pi r square, that is 44 square. So cancel this 4 pi, okay, and simplify this. So I can say 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 into 22 by 44 bracket square. Correct. So how much? 22 2s are 44. So 1 by 2 square. So here we can say 3 by 4 10 to the power minus 4, because this is how much? 1 by 2 square will be 1 by 4. So I said 3 by 4 into 10 to the power minus 5. So that gave me 0.75 10 to the power minus 4. Correct. Or I can say 7.5 10 to the power minus 5 watts per meter square. This is the way we can solve the simplest question by using the formula intensity is equal to power divided by area. So area distance, that can matter definitely, but this is the way we can simply check that how the sound is emitted uniformly in all directions by the public address system. Fine. Now we'll move towards the last question. Now the last question: a steel wire 0.72 meters long has mass of 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg. So we can say length is 0.72 meters and mass is 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg. If the wire is under a tension of 60 newtons, so we can say either tension is 60 newtons, what is the speed of the transverse wave? So obviously the simple formula, T by mu, and the value of mu is mass per length. So mass is 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg divided by 0.72 meters. This is kg, right? So if we simplify this, we get the answer around 6.94 10 to the power minus 3. Fine. Substitute the values over here, so we get C is equal to 60 divided by 0.006694. So if you simplify this, you get the answer to be around 93.24 meters per second. So this is the way we can simply get the answer for the speed of the transverse wave on the wire. Okay, so these are the few questions which are there unsolved on the last on the chapter number 4, which is wave motion. Okay, thank you very much.